We're going to name alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. So an alkane, this is when you have all single bonds in between the carbons in this hydrocarbon, in the carbon chain. We end the name of this carbon chain with A-N-E, ane, to indicate that it's an alkane. It does have a general formula. N is going to be the number of carbons, so CnH2n plus 2. So I went with a really simple alkane. I have two carbons, and notice we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Look at the math right here. If I put 2 right there, so C2, let's go ahead and do this. I'd have C2H2 times 2 plus 2 is going to give me C2H6, and there it is. Now the name for this, so I always count the number of carbons, 1, 2, and I go to my prefixes. All right, two carbons is called eth. So this would be eth, and then I notice there is a single bond, all single bonds in between the carbons, so that is called ethane. That's ethane right there. Let's go to the next one. Alkene, this is when you have a double bond somewhere in that that chain of carbons. So the generalized formula on this is CnH2n, and that's when you have one double bond in the long chain of carbons. The ending on this is ene, E-N-E. So here I have, again, for the same example, two carbons, but now there's a double bond. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 hydrogens. Check out this math over here. You've got your carbon, two of those. Hydrogen, you take two times the two carbons, is going to give me C2H4, and there it is. Now what's this called? Again, count the carbons, I've got 1, 2. So two carbons is eth, and because we have a double bond, you put the ending E-N-E, and that is called ethene. Let's do our last one. Alkynes, Y-N-E, so you pronounce that with an I, alkyne. This means that you have at least one triple bond in that chain of carbons. Here's your formula. It's going to be C(NH)(2n-2). So here's an example. I've got my two carbons with the triple bond, and so we only have one hydrogen on each of those carbons. If we plug in, do the math, we've got two carbons and an H, two times two carbons, that's your N, minus two. We're going to get C2H2, and sure enough, that's the chemical formula. The ending for alkyne is the Y-N-E, so let's name this. Okay, I've got my two carbons, of course. That's going to be eth for two carbons. Because I have a triple bond, this will be called ine. That is ethine. So really, really simple example there. Let's extend it just a little bit. So we're going to remember all of this. I'm going to go ahead and make some room for us. I'm going to put up a couple of formulas for you of alkane, alkyne, and an alkene. All right, let's do, we have three carbons, and I want to name these. Okay, so first thing I always do is count my carbons. 1, 2, 3. The prefix for 3 is prop. Then I look at the bonds. They're all single bonds. So this is going to be an alkane, classified as an alkane. The ending for single bonds, alkanes, A-N-E. So this is propane. This is what we use for our barbecue grill. Those great big white round containers, they hold propane gas. Okay, let's do another one. Let's do, okay, let's see. Okay, oh, and on this, we're going to have a C3H8. Okay, so I want to name this. First thing I do, count the carbons. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. My prefix for 4 is bute. Now, I look at all of the bonds. Ooh, there's a double bond. Right there, I see a double bond. So the ending is going to be the E-N-E. Now, here's the deal, and you might be asking yourself this question. Well, you could put a double bond three different places. How does the reader know that the double bond is on that first carbon? Well, what we do is we number carbons, and the rule is you always give the carbon first touching the multiple bond, the double bond in this situation, you give it the lowest number possible. So you always have two options. You can number left to right, right to left. So let's do both ways. I might have, if I number my carbons, I'd have 1, 2, 3, 4. So looking at these carbons, the lowest number carbon that touches the double bond is 1, okay? So keep that in your head. Well, let's try the other way. I'm going to number 1, 2, 3, 4. Going from right to left, the first carbon, the lowest number carbon that touches the double bond is a 3. So you always choose to number it with the lowest carbon number. So I would number this as 1-butene. And that tells the reader, oh, put a double bond on that first carbon right here. We would take this way of numbering from left to right. Okay, let's do another one. Let's do an example for an alkyne. Okay, we'll go a little bit bigger for this one. Oh, sorry. It's getting kind of purpley there, isn't it? We'll pull out my old rag. That will make it look a little bit better. Okay, let's do a bigger one. So we'll have, Okay, there we have it. Let's put all of our hydrogens. Okay, right, all of those hydrogens on there. First thing that we're going to do is count the number of carbons. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbons. So 6 carbons, let's come here, 6 carbons. The prefix is hex. Now I notice that triple bond, so I know that the ending is going to be Y-N-E, ine. This is going to be a hexine. But we've got to tell the reader, where is that triple bond? So again, two options of how we can number this. Let's go left to right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so the first carbon, lowest number carbon that touches the triple bond here is the 3. Let's try the other direction, right to left. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so looking this way, check it out. The lowest carbon number to touch the triple bond is a 3. So it doesn't matter which way we number it, this is going to be a 3 hexine. And notice how I put a dash between the number and the name. That's going to be a 3 hexine. Okay, so just really, really basic prefixes, alkane, alkene, alkyne. That gives you a good start on naming your organic compounds. Thank you.